everybody. It's Grandma Kelly, Clean Life, Clean Living. I am at Mercer Island. I am at Luther Burbank Park. I tried to get a picture of the, and when I entered the park, but somebody was having a little bit of problem leaving the playground. So I didn't want you to hear the kids screaming bloody murder because it was time to go home. The weather's kind of a bit dicey. I have an hour till sunset, but I wanted to get the magnet in today for a while. This place is amazing. Okay, there is tons. Oop, let's see if I can put you a little bit farther forward if that will help. Anyway, there are tons of docks here to fish off of. So I'm gonna go get the magnet wet. They have a great playground. They have bathrooms, all kinds of things. I don't know how crazy this place is in the summer, but right now I'm gonna start dipping and we'll see what we get today, okay? Great. With my little guy, even though I have the double-sided with me today and ready to go, I've just never been here and I'm afraid I'm gonna catch something heavy really quick. Anyway, if you hear the kids and stuff in the background, there's some people right down the way getting their picture taken by a professional photographer. This is really, really a beautiful place. The weather is not beautiful right now. I had this, remember we had this other problem in the last video too. Untying your knots, taking patience, wah, 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 Kelly. Why are you doing this again? Anyway, I washed this out last night, laid it out to dry, untangled it this morning, put it in my box, and somehow the magnet fairies must have got in my box and tied up my magnet because they want to test my overall patience for the day. Of course, I'm very patient because I get a magnet fish today. But I think right off the bat here, as soon as I get this untangled, the jacket is going on because it is not warm today. It is not warm at all. In fact, I'm pretty sure the rain is going to be coming pretty soon. And I think I need to move my camera just in case. Wow, I think I tied that up more. Just in case it blows over, okay? Give me a second. I think some of this has to be cut out because this is too long and untangling. The stand might blow over. I think what I'll do though is get my jacket on and lower the stand. One day, with you guys' help, I will be the professional magnet grower. But remember, this is a process. Anything you start is a process. The most important part is starting and not giving up and keep working towards. Okay, I'm gonna turn this off for a minute and get this done, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I did it. I got it all tangled. Here we go. I hope you can see me good enough. At the other park, we have a rail, so I know. But I'm gonna just start off this side, and let's get throwing the magnet. Okay, we're gonna start off with my little guy, because I get on. Bunch of googly glop, but we got a nail. Yay, nail. A whole bunch of little metal things too. Oh. again today. I'm just using the single-sided. I think I'm gonna save the double-sided for a day that I can get it stuck. Okay. Let's see what we're gonna get. Feels so much stuff down here. I hope you can hear me. I know I'm kind of far away, but I'm used to having railings, and this place has no railings. Which I guess is good and bad. I think if I brought kids here, I would just make sure that they had life jackets on. I really would make sure if they're out on these docks, because it is not shallow, and it's quite a ways down there. Let's see, what did we get? Nothing really. We got a little magnetic rock. Do this like the professionals do it, and off we go. Are we ready? Here we go. Oh, off it goes. Pretty deep. As if I don't get stuck on something. It's really nice. There's a family out here getting their pictures done by a professional photographer. Boy, if I got tired, I could probably sit on my basket for a little. Ooh, that's something heavy. Ah, I got something heavy. Let's get over here, pull it up, and not mess up the rope. Whoa, oh, it's a lot. It was heavy, but I felt it. I must not be doing it too smooth. There was something big on that. And it was on that almost all the way up. And it wasn't just the salad. There's a lot of salad. Nothing in the salad. Fox salad, be free, okay? Do it like the professionals, one, two, three. Right? Here we go. Oh, no knots. Maybe we'll go four. Let's go a little more off the end here. I know, I might get brave before this is over. Whoa, look at the rope go. How deep is it? It's pretty deep. Okay, let's see what I can get from here. My face is so itchy. I think it's my loose hair going around. Now I see why people wear bandanas and hats and all those other things. Yeah. So how's everybody's day today? Did you guys have a good day at work? Yeah, I cleaned two bigger houses today. The last one ended up on Mercer Island. That's why I'm here. I think this is one. I come to Mercer Island last two times a week. And this is a park that I could actually come to several times. This would be really fun. There's so much stuff here. So many places going out that I could possibly fish from. Magnet fish from. And, oh, look at all the salad. Be gone, salad. Be gone, you. Oh, we did get something. Let's see, what did we get? We got a bottle cap. Really? Do I have to talk to people here? Let's see if I can get some of the sludge out of the bottle cap. Ding, ding. Clean it up, clean it up, clean it up. Let's see, did we lose it in the process now? No, I didn't really get all that clean either. Let's see, what kind is it? Oh my gosh, I can't even read it. And then we got a couple of magnetic rocks, but we got a gold bottle cap. So again, I found gold today. Oh, sorry. Again, I found gold today. Oh, I was a little off on that. Let's give the shallower side a try. I really have this nailed down so it doesn't fall. Let's go off the shallower side and see what happens, okay? I see some logs. There's logs out there a bit. But I really don't think I'm that strong. I can throw it that far, but maybe there's others up here. Let's give this a toss in and see what we find. About that way is really far deep. Let's see. Well, not so deep on this side, that's for sure. We could kind of dump a kayak down here and dip everywhere. That would be fun. So, magnet fishing, this one I think would be a good place to come and be able to throw the magnet around a few times after work at the end of. probably do it for it. This is what we did. We did get a nail right off the bat too. And I did stick on something. Subscribers today, which is a start, isn't it? It's fabulous. Thank you guys for watching my videos and sharing my videos. I appreciate that. I promise the content will get better and better as I get more time to actually get out here and do it, but I'm not trying to have an hour. Nail. It's a wood dock. Part of it's wood. Of course there's going to be nails. I'm going to throw it over by this dock that's sticking out here and pull it back this way. Ooh, that was a knot. No knot. We are not free magnet fishing. Not free. K-N-O-T not free. Let's see. Where do I end up? Tomorrow I end up over by Bothell. I'd really like to go over to Silver Lake. They have a place called Heritage Park there that has a dock off it. I thought that would kind of be interesting. Don't know for sure. But it depends on when I get done. Tomorrow could be an earlier day, but I don't know what my kid driving commitment is yet. Nothing there either. Okay, let's turn you back around. Let's go off the deep side. Because I think if you're going to throw something valuable, you might throw it off this side. I don't know. What valuable thing? This is not about finding riches. It's not about finding treasures. I like the way the guys say treats. What I really like is cleaning out the waters. And like I said before, a good magnet fishing day is poor content because I don't get anything. That means our waterway is clear. Right? Which is a good thing. We have a guy out over here fishing. So again, this is another place I could bring Tony and he could magnet fish for a while. And then he could fish. Wonder what he's probably also fishing for perch because the guys on the other side over that way were fishing for perch. So I can't imagine it would be much different. Ooh, I'm feeling things are sticking to. It's sticky. But is it just the magnetic rocks? Is it rock? Or is it something else? Okay, who thinks I should put out my big magnet? Okay, that's it. I'm gonna pull out the big magnet and see if I find something more. Oh, but what if I get it stuck? I get worried about that. Oh, what is that? I don't know, it's something magnetic and that's a piece of something else magnetic. It's just a little like this kind of slaggy stuff. But it is magnetic. Okay. As the other guys say, let's do it. Let's do it. You guys know who you are over in the UK who say that. Okay, let's pull out the big guy. Let's see if Grandma Kelly can even throw the big guy. Ready? Let's do it. Now you know who I watch and I make fun of. Can't remember those guys' names. I just know they're in my save stuff and they come out and they're so funny. I know one of the guys' name is Ben, and then there's two other blonde hair guys, and one of them's really, really funny. Okay, guys. So see, this is it. This is the big bad boy. Ah! Do you think I can throw it? It's so heavy. Oh my gosh. It's so heavy. Oh, I will not cry if I lose it. I will not cry if I get it. Learn a lesson. Okay, now this is brand new. See, it's tangled up too, but maybe, just maybe, that's part of my lesson in life. Just patiently untangle things. Even when I was a little kid, tangled up and stuff like that, because for some reason, no matter what, I could get it untangled. Okay, now, I just want to say, I don't think I can throw this very far this year, okay? But, as I get stronger, I will be able to throw it farther, and that's what what happens when you do any exercise or start anything new. You start getting stronger and stronger, and you can throw it farther and farther. Okay, I forgot, because I'm a good magnet here, I forgot how many this was. The pulling force, I know it's a brute box, double-sided. If I was smart, I got one of the lightest double-sided. I think I did. Hope I did. And we're going to just see how strong Grandma Kelly is, but she needs to get this turd off. Come on. There we go. Not so bad. Look at all these twisties in it. Is that why they get knot so easy? Because all these twisties. So when I get a new magnet, let's get this tied off. I should sit down and open up the rope and untwist it, right? Does that make sense? Okay, don't do this with your teeth. Very unhealthy and bad. Don't do it. Just because I do it doesn't mean you do it. Okay, we are tied in. What does that mean? When this heavy magnet goes, it'll take me with it. And I will be at the bottom of the sea. Carabiner, no, stuck. Is carabiner nice and tight? Nice. Oh, holy moly, this is heavy. Super heavy. Oh, naughty, naughty. Go nuts. Let's go. Are we ready? Time to build some muscle. Or time to really get it stuck. But it's a double magnet, a sided magnet, so you're supposed to just pull it along the side, on the ground better, right? Let's see what it does. It feels so heavy. I can't imagine what it feels like when there's actually something on it. Right?
across the river water.
You can do it. You can do it, Grandma.
You can do it.
Oh, this is going to be cool. What did I catch? I caught a carabiner. Carabiner. Okay, let's try that again. Let's see if we can do it better. I'm going to do it now, though. We'll let up nothing. Then we'll give it a big toss. This doesn't have a fence I have to go over, or, you know, a railing. Now that was better enough. Whew. Doing this, maybe we'll get all the little knotties out of it. Actually, this place, you could stand up, throw it in, and then sit down to pull it up. Because it's heavier, it will also go down in the muck more, right? Is that logical? Oh, what do we get on this one? Woohoo! Carabiner, stay off there. We got, oops, didn't mean to do that. This funny little piece of something. Cool, cool. Metal. Let's try that again. Right? Wind it up. 1, 2, 3. Oop, oop, don't tangle it. 4. Let's see if we can do that. Are we ready? You ready? 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Ah. Holy crud, that's heavy. No, no knots. Let's take a second and undo our knots as we go. Like life. When life puts you in knots, sit down and quietly and peacefully untangle those knots. Ooh, ooh, catching, 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 catching. One thing about being at the end of the dock is I don't think I'll catch many people walking by. And I want to say this too about this magnet. Whether or not I have something on it, it feels super heavy. I think I might lose the jacket in a minute. Woo! Woo! Well, I didn't catch the carabiner. That's fine. Is that still real tight? Yeah. Oh, another little piece of metal. It is picking up other stuff that one didn't. Just a little guy there. One more little twig. Can you still see me? Good. 3. 4. Oh, that kind of caught my finger. That wasn't so good. Ooh, 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 doesn't fall off. That kind of caught fingers with it. Turn you this way some more. You go more straight off and see what I get. Private. It's private property. I don't know that. Okay, here we go. Gotta untangle from the dock. Okay. We throw it out as far as we can. Are we ready? I feel like feel awkward with my jacket. But let's see if I don't get too cold. Okay, jacket on the ground in between the buckets so the wind won't kick her away. I should turn you guys around, and over here is two little places. Ooh, windy, where people put their boats, get in and out of their boats. Maybe down here. Can you see me?
Yeah, maybe I need to fit in here.
What do you think? Well, that's one way to move your rope over, right? I'm gonna go dip. It's gonna be a bit of ways from you guys, but hopefully you can still see me. See over there? I'm gonna head over that way. We're gonna dip our way around.
pulling out?
Reels, mostly.
Oh, really?
Magnet fishing.
Oh.
Have you ever seen it? I have YouTube going, so.
Oh, right on.
If you're hiding, don't get closer. Come on, say hi.
Hi, everybody. That's cool. I'm not here from San Jose.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I just did some work down here.
Nice.
Yeah, well, I had to get out of the room, you know?
About this knife. Those look just like the knives that we use in the kitchen. So those would probably be Amazon cheapies. But I caught a knife. Yay! How funny. Okay, back over we go. See how that goes. How fun. Got my first knife. Oh yeah. Okay, it's an Amazon basic product knife. I have them in my kitchen. I'm gonna bet most people have them in their kitchen. That's okay. It's still fun. It's still metal. It's still out of the water. Yay! How funny. Okay. So, I have to say, that must be the find of the day, right? Oh my. How funny. Somebody was making lunch on their little boat and dropped the knife over the side. How sad. People would be around this little area here, pulling in their boats, letting people on and off their boats. Of course, that was probably during the summer when it was a whole lot nicer. That's funny. Cutting their cheese platter with her wine. Oh my gosh, that was a tragedy if you lost a knife. Oh, I can see it now. The romantic lunch at the beach. The wine and the cheese and the little kitchen knife, little kitchen steak knife, and you've lost it overboard. You'd have to just like chunk up and eat the cheese, right? Because you wouldn't be able to slice it anymore. Oh, that would be sad. That's why you pre-slice cheese, guys. I don't know. I just say don't eat the cheese. Oh, that's funny. Oh my, that's really funny. Okay, so what is the trick to get the carabiner not to do that? I bet you can. I bet there's something you can do about it. Okay, that's okay. Let's go so for some more. Okay. So we can go alongside this guy then. I know what I should do is get Karina to make me a sweatshirt and a hoodie. And she made this really pretty earth green and put it on the back of Grandma Kelly's Clean Life Clean Living, huh? Yeah, that would be fun. That would really be fun. So you guys know, the less stuff we get, the better clean the water already is with metals. And that just has to somehow be good, right? I know everybody wants like the big bucket of scrap, but we live in the Pacific Northwest, and we need to be extremely grateful that we don't have those rivers that are so polluted and so bad. I'm sure we have some. That the magnet fishers can get piece after piece with every drill. Thank you.
throw a net in for a while, you'll be warm.
Yeah, right. I caught a buddy fishing, and he went around the building in the ocean. He takes me to wear a t-shirt. About to hold the belt and go. Yeah, you start doing some work, you get warm.
Yeah, you do. And this is a stronger magnet than my other one.
Okay.
So I'm feeling warm. Feeling my age.
You did good.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
You too. Thank you so much. Pull it in here. That's gone something because I got creative, right? It gets so funny.
How dark it really is. It's really dark. It's trying to get really dark.
But I feel safer out here. I don't know why. Okay, let's see. If I go this way, can you see me some more? My legs are getting stiff. It's pretty cool. But let's go this way and go in between. Okay? Catch carabiner.
tired. Magnet's heavy. Last little find. It's a little tiny bungee cord. Okay, so I'll step back a bit. This is a lot heavier. Ooh, work some muscles out. That's the idea, right? Okay, again, guys, it is past sunset. It is time to go home. It is also getting very, very chilly. Time to put my jacket back on. This is Grandma Kelly. Clean life, clean living. Please get out and do anything, just something outside that'll help your day relax and help you feel better. Remember, you don't have to make things into very, very big things to have a good time. Okay? See you, love you, bye. Hi everybody, this is Grandma Kelly's Clean Life, Clean Living. I tried to get a picture of this on my way into the park, but some little girl was very unhappy that playtime was over and she had to leave the play area. So I'm gonna put this at the front, even though it's at the end. This is Luther Burbank Park. It is big. There's all kinds of possibilities to do all kinds of things with. When I'm feeling stronger, more energetic, we'll go and do a whole tour of the whole park maybe one day, or I'll split it up. It's really pretty. It's really nice. The people I met were nice. Anyway, had fun. It's on Mercer Island. It's a good place for me to go at the last moment after I'm done with my last house on Mercer Island. Okay, see you, love you, bye.